Destination Mark.
Hey guys, how's it going? Marceller here, and we've got a patch for Spyro Reignited Trilogy, and it's got a lot of neat additions and fixes that we're going to go over, or at least some of them. Here are most of the fixes and changes. This is everything that patch 1.03 has to offer. So we're going to go over some of these things and show you the two main differences that everyone's talking about. First off, we've got subtitles across all three games and the cutscenes, and that's pretty cool. And in Spyro 1 in particular, you can also see the subtitles when you free the dragons. They're awesome, they're stylized, they're different colors depending on the dragons and the characters who are talking. And I like that they're having fun with the punctuation and with the subtitles in general, because look at Nasty Nork and him yelling and all those question marks and exclamation marks. That's pretty funny. And if you prefer the subtitles off, you can toggle them on or off in the options menu. Another neat addition is to toggle on or off the motion blur, which people have been wanting since the game released. So here's me playing with it on, and here's me playing with it off. And while it was off, I noticed that the game looked a bit more crisp. Something about it was cleaner. I mean, yeah, of course, motion blur kind of smears the background as you move the camera. But not even just the obvious. I mean, the colors really pop this time around. I think that they did something with the visuals, maybe the shading and the lighting. But something about it, whether the motion blur is turned on or off, it seems more vibrant. So I don't know if that's me or not, but regardless, that's pretty cool. And I finally got the chance to try out the sunglasses cheat and the retro Spyro cheat. The sunglasses cheat is pretty standard. It's just Spyro with sunglasses, and it's really cool. Now with the retro cheat, I've got at least one thing to say about it. Well, on one hand, it looks really cool and does harken back to the way Spyro looked in the old games. You gotta keep in mind, this isn't the PS1 model, it's still Reignited, just altered to emulate the PS1 style. And one thing that always bugged me about the way this cheat looked, Spyro's eyebrows look a little bit too big. I know they're trying to go for the whole they go across and dip down. I mean, even his Reignited eyebrows kind of look that way. But since they were very blocky for the polygonal model, they were trying to emulate that here, and it kind of works, but kind of doesn't, because it looks like they're boxing his face in a bit more, like his eyes. I don't know, I think they made it a bit too polygonal. And if I'm honest, I kind of wish they added a bit more detail. I mean, I know the whole point of low poly is to make it look less detailed, but to be honest, even the PS1 model had a lot of detail. But nonetheless, playing with that skin turned on made it look really cool. I mean, it still looks nice, so I don't have too much to complain about it. Just that one little nitpick. And that's about it. With this patch, everything looks nicer, it's cleaner, you can have motion blur on or off, you can have subtitles on or off. And in certain levels throughout the three games, there are even more very subtle tweaks. So if you happen to notice that while you're playing, that's pretty cool. Of course, there are still some things that they could fix, some pretty big things, but I'll make another video about that in the future. For now, this is what we have, and it's a really neat improvement. What do you guys think of patch 1.03? Let me know in the comments down below. Until then, I'm Marcelo. I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching, and take care.